Hello all, this is Sandeep Mandal from Des Engineering, and we will be discussing a conjugate heat transfer analysis on ANSYS Fluent, how it can be done and how to import a model, how to do a pre-processing for that, and similarly all the result extraction as described in the previous video of pipe flow through pipe analysis. So let's begin with the video. I'm first importing a catalytic converter basic model into ANSYS Fluent, and then I'm doing a pre-processing for that so that heat distribution over a metallic surface or fluid region can be detected. So here I opened ANSYS Fluent model 2019 version 2. First import a fluid flow fluent into the main working area. So after importing a fluid flow volume, if you want to rename it. Then the next process is to open a space claim and do some pre-geometry clearation into a model. So I'm just opening a space claim module by double clicking on this geometry. So here our space claim module is opened up, and we have to drag our catalytic converter geometry into it. So go to this open module, and from here you have to choose our geometry which I have already created. So the geometry is in desktop catalytic converter, and go for step. Here you will find that option. Okay, so this is the solid work part. Now you can import this. After importing, you have to do some pre-processing, such as removing the extra line edges for contouring action to be overlapped, and the process is basically called as repairing process. So we have to do this repairing process. So let me hold for geometry to import first. So it seems that our SolidWork model is successfully imported in the space claim module. So I'm just going for repair and check for extra edges. So there are no area found, so our geometry is clear. So we have to create a fluid flow volume. So volume extraction method, I'll be using a edge selection method, selecting this edge and this edge, internal edge. After selecting both the edges, click on OK so that fluid flow volume can be extracted from the model, and it is successfully extracted. So we have this solid model and we have volume. So in this conjugate heat transfer analysis or a heat transfer analysis, we have to see a behavior of heat on the surface of catalytic body, so this solid body. Okay, also I'll be providing a region where this volume is covered or filled with a air having certain velocity or temperature. Okay, now it's time to save a model into a particular location. After saving that model, we can go for further processing. So after saving it, close space claim and go for meshing. So after closing space claim, it seems that geometry was not uploaded in the geometry module, so we have to right click it, and we have to go for that location where we previously saved our body. So by right clicking, we can do that. So go for here, import geometry, browse, and from browse panel select that geometry. So this is that geometry. So here you'll see after some time tick mark will be appear. Go for meshing now. So So now our model is successfully imported in meshing module. Here we have to create a meshing. So make sure your share topology option will be okay in the space claim module, so that both the bodies should share a mesh. So let's generate a default mesh for this. After creating or generating a default mesh, we have to create a named selection. So for better analysis or better visualization of heat distribution over a convective surface of solid model, you have to go for finer mesh. But for the demonstration purpose, I'll be going with a basic mesh. So let's start with meshing named selection. Select this face and type N, and name it as inlet. Again, go for this surface and select it as outlet. And this upper surface will be your outer wall convection, where you want to see a convective results. So you have to do this only. After doing this, you can close the module. So after closing meshing, go for here and update a solution or update a geometry in meshing module by right clicking. So after successfully imported and updating a geometry, go for setup and run a ANSYS Fluent simulation. Here we are providing basic velocity and thermal condition on a model, and basic equation, Navier-Stokes equation to be solved depending upon the mesh criteria or the cell generated. So here our Fluent model is successfully imported our geometry. So this is the geometry. The blue region indicates inlet and red region indicates outlet. Depending upon other parameters are also generated with the displaying console, and this is the console window. Now I am going to use a pressure vest and absolute velocity formulation condition, and here I am only focusing on end result, that's why I am using a steady state analysis. You can also include a gravity condition, but I'm not including in this simulation. So go for physics model, energy equation on. We have to set a viscous model to K epsilon model, and we can also use this RNG, but standard is base. So we should go for this basic condition of K epsilon model with Prandtl number 1.3 with standard wall function. After doing that, check a material. So ANSYS Fluent default take material as air, so we do not have to edit any type of material here. Now go for boundary conditions. We have to provide a boundary condition to inlet and outlet. So inlet, velocity inlet, I'm going to give it a velocity inlet with a particular velocity at inlet and temperature. So give a velocity of 20 meter per second. No, give it as 6 meter per second. And make it a temperature at inlet is minor of 700 Kelvin. So the exhaust gas is coming out from engine. Approximately we are on the end user result or end user values. you can vary this inlet condition. Now outer wall convection, we have provided this. So for outer wall convection, we have to provide a thermal conductivity value, and by default it took a solid geometry as aluminium. So here you will see that aluminium material is there. From this convection, we have to provide a convective value for this heat transfer coefficient. So I'm giving it as 20 and select OK. You can vary the values as per your condition, as per your result wantings. So yeah, I set all this pre-processing or pre-processed all the model. After doing all this, we have to initialize and create an isoplane so that we can see the contours of variation. So go for solutions. No, go for solutions, and hybrid initialization has to be done. So hybrid initialization create 10 points. It is an incremental value for the solution, or it's a base construction value. Now go for residuals and flux report. I want a mass flow rate at outlet. So mass flow rate at outlet, report that file and report a plot and click on OK. Now what we have to do is we have to create a plane. On that plane we would see, so pointing to Z, point to normal is Z direction. So I'm giving a value Z is 1. So plane is perpendicular to that axis. So create, hit create, plane is created. Now select for contour. So contour 1 should be our temperature variation at plane 11. Save and display. So this is the temperature variation. Okay, now again we have to create a second contour for let's see velocity. For velocity, plane this, save and display. So this are the velocity generation. Now again we have to create a pressure distribution. Suppose we have to see a pressure distribution, static pressure at plane 11, save and display. So we can also create animation for both these three results, pressure, temperature and velocity variation. So go for the solution animation, select contour 1, use active and OK. Again go for this solution animation 2, contour 2, use active, OK. Solution animation, animation 3, contour 3, use active, OK. Now your animation has to be developed after calculating all these values. So let's go for run calculation, and let's say I'm running it for 200 iteration. You can also increase the iterative values because my meshing is coarse, that's why I'm using less iterative values, because I know my results are not as good as compared to a finer mesh. finally, it seems that the result is converged, or all the results are manually created. Sorry, not manually created. All the animation files are read in the console window. So let's see the result here. This is the residual plots. It ran for 200 iteration. If you do a finer meshing and then do then calculate residuals, then it might be a same. These lines are following into same contour after 200 to 200 iteration. Maybe you should try 500 iteration with finer meshing. So these are the mass flow rate we are getting at outlet. It seems that it is converged and it is constant at outlet. So after 80 or after 65 iteration, the mass flow rate is being constant. So it seems that our result is good, not a better result. It's a good result. So you'll see the mass flow rate is continuously decreasing because our inlet region having a diameter of having a bigger diameter than the outlet region. That's why at the outlet we are getting a lesser mass flow rate. So these are the temperature variation. You'll see that 700 degrees Celsius is almost all in the all region, and you'll see this line. These are the solid body where convection process is taking place. So you'll see that approximate at this yellow region, 612. It is the 612 Kelvin is at the end of this, at the starting of a internal body, and at the outside it is somewhat 545 Kelvin. So you can see the convection is taking place from internal fluid region to the solid body, which we have gave a material as aluminium and thermal convective coefficient as 20 watt per meter Kelvin. Now the velocity variation, these are the velocity variation. You'll see at the inlet the velocity is somewhat 7.29 meter per second, as I given the velocity of 7 meter per second. So these are the velocity contour. So as we are going on increasing our increasing the length or accelerating our point cursor towards this bigger region, so the velocity is decreasing at the outer region, and again it is increasing at this outlet region. It approximately maximum velocity production is 12 meter per second at the outlet. So after that, pressure. So these are the pressure contours. We have seen in Venturi action that area, wherever the area is there, pressure is higher, and the area is lower, then the pressure is lower and velocity is suddenly increasing. So those principles are valid here. Area is bigger, pressure is higher. Area is smaller, pressure is going to this. Sorry, pressure is continuously reducing. So to run animations, to plot a mass flow rate at this console window, go for this report definition, double click on that and click on OK. Sorry, double click on that and click on compute. So this is the mass flow rate at outlet you will be getting. So this is the console window, and to run a solution animation, go for the solution animation, double click on that, and these are the animation result you will be seeing. So click on this, play. So let's see what variation we will be having in this temperature, static temperature condition. It seems that the temperature is almost constant in this region because the velocity is very higher. You can go for the lower velocity boundary condition. So let me check our second animation as this velocity magnitude, how the velocity is varying. So you'll see this is the velocity variation we will be seeing in this body. Again, go for third result and play this animation. So these are the pressure distribution animation. So in this way you can do a thermal analysis on catalytic converter or related feature or related body. You can import a solid model as well as the fluid region into a solid fluid flow fluent, and by providing a specific convective value you can do the heat transfer analysis very well. You can also go for the transient heat transfer and lumped parameter analysis. So with this I would like to conclude my video. You can follow this. These are the basic process you can follow and practice it at home. By varying a model variation you can do the research on this on various topics. Thank you for watching this video.